क्यूबिक इक्वेशन। This is the format. Ax square plus ax cube bx square cx plus d equals to c. This is the cubic equation. If alpha, beta, gamma are the roots, then you can see that x minus alpha into x minus beta into x minus gamma equal to zero. One and two have same set of roots. Therefore, one and two are identical. Two equations are identical means they have the same set of roots. Two equations are identical. Equation number two, if you multiply, you will get like this: x cube minus alpha plus beta plus gamma into x square. Next, alpha, beta, beta, gamma, gamma, alpha into x minus alpha, beta, gamma equals zero. This is our equation number two only. 1 and 2 are identical. 1 and 2 are identical means coefficients are proportional. So 1 and 2 are identical. What is the meaning? Coefficients are coefficients of 1 and 2. These are proportional. So you can see that. So from this you can compare this. You can see that 1 by a equal to minus alpha plus beta plus gamma dividing by b. Now alpha, beta, beta, gamma, gamma, alpha dividing by c minus alpha, beta, gamma dividing by d. This way we can compare a, b, c, d. So in first equation you can see that alpha plus beta plus gamma. This guy can notation be as sigma alpha. This become minus b by a. Now sigma alpha beta means that is coming out be c by a. So this is the case. Now next one is alpha beta gamma. This become minus b by a. Minus b by a. We'll get better this one. Alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to minus b by a. Alpha, beta, gamma. Alpha, beta, beta, gamma, gamma, alpha is coming out b. C by a. That way we can calculate all of this. Clear again?
Yes, sir.
Now this is the normal way to write in cubic equation. Let me give one example. Please try. They are giving like this. If alpha, beta, gamma, these are the roots of 10x cube, 11x square plus 1. Then they are asking what is 1 by alpha, beta, beta, gamma, gamma alpha. What is the value of this? Please try this one.
There actually it will.
Now you see.
Sir, 11.
11 is the answer. Now you see, yes. you can see that here, always write it like this: 10x cube, 11x square, 0x plus 1 equals 0. Sigma alpha is coming out to be minus 11 by 10. sigma alpha beta is 0, alpha beta gamma is minus 1 by 10. So our LHS is coming out, you can take the LCM. LCM is alpha beta gamma. Numerator is alpha plus beta plus gamma. This is coming out to be minus 11 by 10 dividing by minus 1 by 10. So answer is 11 is the answer. So let me put the next problem now. Please try similar question. This is the problem. Please try. This is the situation. You have to write that quadratic equation in a proper way. That is x cube plus 0x square minus 2x plus 6 equals 0. Sigma alpha becomes 0. Sigma alpha beta become first negative then positive. So minus 2, then alpha beta gamma is negative, minus 6. So we know that this alpha plus beta plus gamma equals 0. Then we have the identity. Alpha cube plus beta cube plus gamma cube equal to 3 alpha beta gamma. So if you are going to put that value here, I think answer is coming out to be minus 18 beta. This is the answer you are getting. Whenever alpha plus beta plus gamma are the roots, then this is the way we want to.
Yes.
मिल गया क्या?
Yes.
Next problem. They are giving R, S, T are the roots of this quadratic equation. Then they are going to ask R plus S cube, S plus T cube, T plus R cube. What I said, R plus S cube, S plus T cube, T plus R cube. What is the value of this? Now here they are giving 8x cube plus 0x square 1001x 2080 equals 0. So sum of the roots R plus S plus T equals 0. Sigma R into S. This is coming out to be 1001 dividing by 8. RST. RST is coming out to be 2008 dividing by 1001. Now R plus here R plus S equal to minus T only. R plus S equal to minus T. S plus T equal to minus R. T plus R is coming out to be minus S. So what is our LHS? Our LHS is coming out to be minus T cube. That means minus T cube, minus R cube, minus S cube. So this is coming out to be, you can take that minus outside. T cube plus or S cube, R cube plus, this is S cube. So R plus S equal to T. R plus S equal to, sorry, R plus S plus T equals 0. So this is equal to minus 3RST. So minus 3 into RST is coming out to be minus 2008 dividing by 1001. This is the things we are getting. RST is this minus 3 times this. So you can calculate this. Can you tell me what will be the answer? R cube 2008. Here I made some little mistake. This is not 1001. This is R S cube.
You see, 1004.
Dividing by 8 only. This is dividing by 8. So this is, so that is why I got confused. This is dividing by 8. dividing by 8. It is divisible by 8 also. So 3 times, you see how much it is coming. Please calculate. 3 times 2 only coming. 2, now 16, 4.
252.
So this is sir, one. We see 5.
Sir, 8 said
756.
Sir, sir, 216 sir, 45 and sir 8 बचेगा क्या लगाना होगा सर? Sir, 251 आएगा.
251 है ना? Okay, 251. जल्दी कर दीजिए. 251. This is one only. So 251. So 753 is coming. The answer is coming out be 753. 753 is the answer to that problem. I hope you got this idea. So this is the situation. R plus S plus T. So R plus S you can replace. S plus T also you can replace. T. Now AQ plus BQ plus EQ. Provided A plus B plus C equals 0 means that is equal to 3ABC. So let me give some similar problem. Now this is the practice section. You please try one by one. Let me put 2-3 questions. Please note down this. The first 2 problem is this one only. And then let me put one comprehension also. Paragraph 5 problem also important. Please do these 4 questions. So you will get a clarity from the concept we discussed. So 2-3 problem we tried ourselves and the remaining 4 you. Please try. Please find out all these 4 questions answer, then we will discuss one by one. Find out one by one. Now this is, you tell me what will be the answer to the first question is A. This is 36. And so this value is also A and this value.
C.
Good. Very good. Now we can move on to the next concept. Let me put it like this. For example, alpha is a root of x square minus 5x plus 6 equal to 0. Alpha is a root of this. Now you see we want to find out an equation whose roots or whose root 1 by r. So we want to get an equation which will satisfy instead of x we can put 1 by r. So you know that alpha here, alpha become 1 by x. So alpha is what they are giving is the root of x square minus 5x plus 6 equal to 0. That means alpha square minus 5 alpha plus 6 equal to 0, because alpha is a root means you can replace x with alpha. Now you see this one. Alpha, instead of alpha, you can put 1 by x. So this is 1 by x square minus 5 into 1 by x plus 6 equals 0. Or taking the LCM, you will get it like this. 6x square minus 5x plus 1 equals 0. You can verify also. This is the given equation. First equation. This is the equation having reciprocal roots. Second equation. So if you take in second, you can find out the x value 5 plus 4 minus 25 b square minus 4ac. That means 24 dividing by 2. That means the roots are coming 2 into a. A ka value 6. So 5 plus 4 minus 1 by 12. So answer is coming 6 by 12. That is 1 by 2. Another is 1 by 3. What was the given equation? Given equation is x square minus 5x plus 6 equals 0. Now clearly this root is coming out b, or we can factorize like this. So roots are coming out b 2 and 3. What are these roots? They are reciprocals. So this is the concept we will extend it to cubic equation also. You see what I said, alpha is a root of x square minus 5x plus 6. You want to find out an equation whose root is 1 by alpha. So we want to find out an equation, we want to replace x with 1 by alpha. So we know that alpha become 1 by x. Alpha is a root of x square minus 5x plus 6. So alpha square minus 5 alpha plus 6, we are going to put alpha equal 1 by x here. So we got an equation. That equation will give x values are the reciprocal to the given values of the given equation having root 2 and 3. Now after using this concept, we are getting an equation whose roots are 1 by 2, 1 by 3. This is the concept. So you should remember whatever may be the situation. So what we will do here, result, let me write it like this. If alpha is root of, we are discussing cubic, ax cube bx square plus cx plus d equals 0, then equation having root 1 by alpha, what is the approach? We know that a alpha cube b alpha square
but dx cube plus cx square plus bx plus a.
Bilkul sahi beta. So what we will do, we want to get equation having x satisfies 1 by alpha. So from here we can put alpha equal to 1 by x here. You will get dx cube, you said correctly, cx square, then bx plus a equals 0. This is the first result. Second one is, whatever may be the equation, alpha is root of OIB equation, fx equals 0. Then equation whose root is, then equation whose root is, they are giving OIB case. I say alpha plus a by alpha plus b. So what we will do, we will denote this by x. From this we will find out alpha. So we will put, we know that f alpha equals 0, that alpha value we will put it here, we will solve the equation. This is the normal approach you should remember. So whatever the roots, we can use this concept. Mil gaya beta? Not that much complicated.
Yes, sir.
Not that much complicated. This is the situation. For example, one example, let me write it. Alpha, if alpha, beta, gamma are the root of this equation, find the equation whose root is 1 by alpha. Very easy problem. Whose root is coming out be 1 by alpha. So first you have to convert this into cubic equation. Please try to do this. We want to expand this.
Sir, so 2x cube plus 6x square plus, sir, plus 7x होगा.
7x है ना?
Yes. So, नहीं, अच्छा, नहीं, sir, नहीं.
6x square, 6x cube आ रहा है. So, this is 7x cube. बिल्कुल सही बोला. 7x cube. 6x square plus 6x
cube. Sir, so 7x cube नहीं होगा. Sir, वो 2x cube होगा.
2x cube, है ना? सही लिखा.
Sir, x plus x cube, sir, x plus x cube plus 6x square plus x cube plus 2 equal to
this. सही लिखा क्या है बेटा? This is
yes,
सही
है ना? Yes, sir, वो सही.
सही है ना?
Yes.
So, 2 alpha cube, 6 alpha square plus alpha plus 2 equals 0. So, we want to find out an equation there, if you replace x with 1 by alpha, that equation we want to satisfy. So alpha equal 1 by x, you can put it here. I think that 2x cube, then this is x square, 6x plus 2 equal to 0 is the required equation. Will you give it up?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Not that much complicated one. You can do it. Next problem. Let me put some problem. You please try to do. Here beta plus alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to 0 only. So beta plus gamma equal to minus alpha, you can replace. We give you three problems. Please try these three problems. Now, this first problem. Let me take that first problem. You see. This is the case, ax cube ax cube here x square term is not there, x square term is not here. So ax cube 0 x square plus bx plus c equal to 0. What we will do, alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to 0 only. So beta plus gamma should be minus alpha. So here you can put it minus alpha by alpha square. So we need the root is minus 1 by alpha. Minus 1 by alpha means we are going to put x equal to minus 1 by alpha. So here we will get what is alpha, that is minus 1 by x. They are already given. Ax cube bx plus c, x equal to alpha satisfies this equation, ax cube plus bx plus c. So we are going to put a alpha cube b alpha plus c equal to 0. Now we want alpha equal to minus 1 by x. We are going to substitute alpha equal to minus 1 by x. So this is minus a by x cube minus b by x plus c equal to 0. Taking the LCM, cx cube minus bx square minus a equal to 0 is the answer. Will you give it up? Agil?
Yes, sir.
Please try the second one also. Second question. Second and third. This is the second one. For clarity, you will get it. Try yourself. So here we have alpha, beta, gamma are the roots of x cube plus bx plus q. So you can see that here also alpha plus beta plus gamma equal to 0. sigma alpha beta is coming out be first negative then positive, so p this is equal to p, then alpha beta gamma equal to minus p. So the equation whose roots are alpha square, so you know that alpha cube plus p alpha plus q equals zero. So we want a cubic equation only because three roots are there. So we will take x equal to alpha square. So from here, what is the value of alpha? Alpha equal to root x. Now we need a cubic equation. So if you put it this value here, so alpha e alpha square equal to x. So this is alpha cube equal to x root x. Then next is p into root x plus q equals zero. So we want to convert this into a cubic equation. So root x is common here. Now the x plus p is coming. This is equal to minus q. So let me square this because we want a cubic equation only. So squaring, we are getting x. This is x plus p ka whole square equal to 2 square. So we are getting x into x square plus 2px plus p
square. Sir, I was asking about second question, not third. Sir, I was asking about second question, not third.
Okay, second. Have you done that second?
Sir, second nahi kya, first kya tha humne pehle.
Okay. You see, anyway, I done this much x cube. If you want, you can tell that time also. This is almost completed. So this is the answer to that one. This is the third problem. Second question is, this is the third problem. You are asking second question now. So let me explain that second question also. There is no problem for this. So this is now this is coming out be, you can see that alpha cube minus alpha square minus 1 equals 0. This is the alpha equation to be satisfied. We need one equation which will satisfy 1 plus alpha. X will satisfy. So from here, x minus alpha x equal to 1 plus alpha. We want to calculate that alpha only. So alpha you will get it like this. Alpha you see x minus 1 dividing by x plus 1. We want to put this value there. So this is x minus 1 x plus 1 whole cube minus x minus 1 x plus 1 whole square plus 1 equals 0. Sorry, minus 1 equals 0. There is not plus 1, it is minus 1. This is minus 1. But I simplify all the angles. Simplifying this, you will get that. Okay, beta.
Yes, sir. So can you show a little bit above?
Okay, this one. This is that.